mean by standardization of drug studies. So first we'll see, so what is this evaluation? So evaluation of natural products, or it is also called as standardization of drug, and it is also called as methods to determine identity, purity and quality of drugs. So that means, so the evaluation of food drugs is also called as the standardization of food drugs in other form, also it is called as methods used to determine the identity and purity and quality of drugs. So that is the evaluation. So what is this evaluation? So evaluation means determining identity, purity and quality or activity of the drug. So the determination of its identity, so the genuinity or virginality of that particular drug, and purity of that particular drug, and quality or the activity of that particular drug is known as evaluation. So it is badly required in case of phytochemical investigations. So the evaluation is a must. So what is this evaluation? The evaluation is also called as the standardization of food drug, or which is also called as methods used to determine identity, purity and quality of drugs. So what is this exactly, the evaluation? So the evaluation means determining its identity, the perfect identification of the particular drug, that is identity and purity of that particular drug, that drug, and also the quality or the activity of the drug. All the parameters, determining three parameters, include the evaluation. So next we will see what do you mean by purity. So purity refers to, so as for the phytochemical investigation on the food drug, means the estimation of active chemical concentration in the drug. So that is, so how much amount of active chemical concentration present, so the determination is called as the purity of food drug. That is, the purity means the estimation of active chemical concentration present in the drug is called as the purity. So what is this quality? So the quality refers to the means determination of drug activity, so the pharmacological activity or the biological activity of the particular drug is called as the quality. If the drug is denied or produced a good drug, so it should possess all these parameters, so that is the idea, it should be identified properly or perfectly, that is denied. So then next is, it can be purity. Purity refers to the so how much percentage of the active chemical concentration is present in the particular drug. It is a one of the parameters for the evaluation, and also the determination of the therapeutic activity. So their biological activity also depends upon their genuinity. So that is the biological activity or the therapeutic activity or the pharmacological activity of the particular drug. So that is called as the evaluation. So once again I will repeat, the evaluation of the natural products, which is also called as the standardization of food drug, or which is also called as the methods used to determine its identity, purity and quality of the drug. So the identity means the exact identification of that particular drug by taxonomical studies or botanical studies. So that is the identification. So what is this purity? Purity is the estimation of the active chemical constituent present in the drug. So how much percentage of the active chemical constituent should be present in the particular virginal drug or the genuine drug, so that is the purity. So the quality, so what is this quality as per the, in simple words, quality means the determination of the therapeutic activity or the pharmacological activity of the particular drug is called as the quality. So next is, so what are the various significances? So why we should go for the evaluation of natural products? Why we should go for the standardization of the food drugs? Why we should go for the determination of identity, purity and quality of the drug? So these are the various significances or the various importance of evaluation of natural products. So one is, so it is helpful for the detection of the adulterate if it is adulterated. Suppose if the drug is adulterated, the adulteration can be detected. So thereby we require the standardization of the food drug. So thereby we require the evaluation of the food drug. Thereby we require the method for the determination of identity, purity and quality of the particular drug. So that is the major significance of going to do for the evaluation of natural products. So that is the
presence of digital transformation project. So what are the various types of digital transformation project? So what are the various types of digital transformation project? So what is the nature of this project? So all these determine how we effectively evaluate the digital project. By doing the particular method, we go for the detection of the digital transformation project. That means there are two important major advantages of this digital transformation or important.
Deterioration
So for the detection of the deterioration also we require the evaluation of natural products. And the substitution and adulteration also, as a result of carelessness and ignorance or fraud to make the money, so that can also be detected in the evaluation of natural products. So these are the three main reasons why we should go for the evaluation of natural products. One is biochemical variation in the drug, deterioration due to treatment and storage, substitution and adulteration, as a result of carelessness, ignorance or fraud, you can say. So the next is, so what are the various methods available? So what are the various standards we should follow to get the genuinity of a particular drug? So these are the various methods we will use. Biological evaluation. So by using the different methods for the evaluation, we can use the more standard and we can predict the more biological activity or quality of the drug. So one is physical methods of evaluation is A. Second is the chemical methods of evaluation. Third is pathological evaluation, microscopical evaluation, spectroscopic evaluation and biological evaluation. So each methods have the significance and they have the different constraints you can say. So the first method you can say physical method of evaluation. So where we will use this physical method of evaluation? So what is this physical method of evaluation? So what are the various parameters we use for the physical methods of evaluation to get the standardization of the particular drug or to evaluate in a genuine manner? So these are, this is the, so what is the physical method of evaluation? So this method is used for the determining of the purity of the two drugs. So only we can determine the purity of the particular drug by using the physical method of evaluation. So only purity can be tested. So percentage of the actual constituents can be tested in case of physical method of evaluation. So that is the, this method is used for the determination of the purity of the food drug. So here they use us, so what are the various parameters they are using? So here they are using the physical constraints, and these constraints they are characteristic of a particular drug. So that means they have the fixed values for a particular drug. So they have the constant value for a particular drug. By maintaining or by observing the reference values, so we can predict the genuinity of a particular drug. We can predict the purity of the particular drug. So that is the physical evaluation. So the physical evaluation only used for the determination of the purity of the drug. Only we can go for the purity identification in case of physical method of evaluation. So here, so what is the, how they are testing the purity? So they will use the physical constraints. So they are constant for a particular food drug. They are characteristic for a particular food drug. So they are the standard values for a particular food drug. Why we should go for the determining of the moisture content? So how it is determined in the laboratory? So what are the various examples for this moisture content? So significant. So the percentage of the active chemical constituent in a food drug is determined on air dry basis. So that is the moisture pool basis. So whenever we are going for the determining of the amount of the active constituent or the bioactive constituent or the percentages, so complete the moisture content can be removed, then the total amount can be determined. Suppose if the moisture content is present, so immediately it undergoes the deterioration. Decomposition of the chemical constituent will happen. So thereby the moisture content is the one of the important parameters to prevent the deterioration of the microbial contamination of that particular drug. So what is the significance is the percentage of the active chemical constituent. So whatever we are getting, this much of amount of active chemical constituent present, so that depends upon the moisture content determination. So after determining the moisture content, we should predict the amount of active constituent present on the same.